Okay, just I will give just a moment. I will give you some quick this one. Yes, this is what we have discussed about this land use capability. So land use capability based on the potential ability to produce the yield. So if you have a land, I think already I have discussed many times, we have the different kind of different land use systems, different types of land. So in that land, is it it is having a potential to produce the required quantity or required the yield level. So based on this, so they have categorized into different category, 8 classes. So this LCC, if you are knowing this land use capability, then only you can go for adapting soil and SWC measures, soil and water conservation measures. So this was developed by this USDA, United State Department of Agriculture. So after classifying this land users, whenever you want to use this land use capability, that you can identify the land suitability to produce that particular crop. This is how this classification is done. I think I very clearly I mentioned that is land slope from class 1 to class 8. From class 1 to class 4, there is the land slope is up to 10%. So up to fourth category, fourth class, we can go for cultivating the crops. After fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh, and eighth, it is not possible to cultivate, but we have to go for conserving the rain soil, and also you can develop the suitable alternate land use systems. I think already I have given here. So we have using these different category using this category of a land with a suitable conservation measures or very careful measures we have to take, and then we can proceed to develop that particular land for the particular purpose. Okay. So next, these, what are the four different categories are there? That is class 1 to 4. In this case, class 1 is there is no problem because there is no erosion. There is no problem for the cultivation. It is a very, very good land. So coming to the second, third, and fourth, it needs some slight conservational measures. So that's why they are again subdivided into the category, subclasses. There are four subclasses. One is the erosion susceptibility and shallow to soil and low water holding capacity. So in this group, classification land use LCC 2, 3 and 4, so they have further divided into these four categories. Based on that particular, the features of the land, by knowing the features of land, they have categorized into the four subgroups. One, erosion susceptibility, so soil, shallow soils and low water holding capacity, and wet soil and also high water holding with a poor drainage. So where there is a poor drainage, definitely that is a wet soil. So that is indirectly that will be knowing. Okay. Climatic conditions are adverse where there is a reason. So if you are categorized this the land, even though it is coming under the second or third or fourth, but so in that area, if it is a climatic condition is adverse, so then you can have subdivided accordingly. They have to go for adapting the conservational measures. Okay, did you clear all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, what's wet soil, sir?
Pardon?
Wet soil,
that means right here. So I already told you there is a land. In that land, if it is a more rain, what happens? If it is drainage is very poor or the infiltration rate is very low, so in that case, what happens? The water holding is high, no doubt. So at the same time, it is always weighted. So in this case, in this category, it needs a different kind of conservational measures. That is why, even though it is that land is coming under the class 2, class 3 or class 4, so that category needs different conservational measures. That is why they have categorized these subclasses.
Okay, sir. Thank
you. Okay. So I think we will move to the other topic. Today's regular business is, yeah. So I think already we have discussed in this in details. So that is, I told you somebody is asking in between the middle of this, classes. So I explained whenever there is a topic is there that I will clarify in detail. So today, I want to go with this. I think this is already all of you well versed to this topics. Biological control or the agronomical control. If you go for the land conservation of rain as well as the water, soil. So these two major category of major types of conservational methods, biological or the agronomical methods, or the second one is mechanical or the engineering measures we have to adapt. So I think this is one where already we have discussed. The first agronomical measures is the just, I told you once again, agronomical measures are the conservational measures in where just manipulating the soil to conserve the maximum rainwater, so to get the highest yield, at the same time it will be reduces the runoff water. That's all. Is it clear all of you? Any doubt?
No, sir.
So this is the one method. Measure, conservational measure, that is contour cultivation. Contour cultivation means contour is nothing but it is the imaginary line. Contour is nothing but imaginary line joining the same elevation on the earth surface. Did you clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So this contour, if you are cultivating the contour, tillage or cultivating that flow or cultivate the land on the contour, that is contour cultivation. This is the agronomical measures. Okay. If you are doing this, what happens? It is opening the furrow or opening the soil across the slope that will help to reduce the flowing water, that is nothing but the velocity of the water, that will be reduces. When there is a velocity of the water reduces, it is having the more time. If it is a more time, what happens? The more water is to be infiltrated. More water is to be infiltrated in the soil, the more moisture is to be held by the soil. So in this way, the maximum water is conserve. At the same time, it is also check the the soil, it is carried along with the runoff water, flowing water. Is it clear, all of you, once again?
Yes, sir.
Very, very nice. See, I think I already told you that this is the one thing I have discussed in the offline classes also. That is first line of defense, that is the agronomical measure. Second line of defense in the conservation of water and soil is the mechanical measures. The first line of defense is the defense control. That is the defense for the agronomical measures, and second defense is the mechanical measures. So I think most of the things I have underlined here. No? So you can just see this. Dissipate the erosive power. That means to say, see, if you are going to apply, if you are going to adapt, if you are going to done the agronomical conservational measures in the land, cultivated land, what it happens, it dissipates the erosive power by the agents. Okay. So that I also one thing you remember here, I underline one word, that is a telase. What do you mean by telase? That is already I told you, that is the manipulation of soil. That is the telase is nothing but manipulation of the soil to create the favorable condition to grow the crop. That's all. Did you clear? What do you mean by telase?
Yes, sir.
Telase is nothing but it is just manipulating the soil by means of opening the soil, breaking the clay, breaking the mass, and to create the very favorable condition to grow and to come up that plant, grow and give the yield. So that is tillage is just simply, I will tell you once again, it is just simply manipulation of the soil to create the congenial or the very good favorable condition for the growing of a crop. That's all. Tillage, I think all of you remember. So contour, next one is, so I think already I told you for contour farming, what happens in this contour farming? See here, if you are doing this contour farming, I have given some 3 points in the right side. So that means it increases the infiltration rate. Is it correct? So 75.
Yes, sir.
So is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So doing the contour farming andre no, so cultivating along the contour andre no, it is the imaginary line same elevation. So if you are doing this contour farming, so what the benefit? It increases the infiltration rate. So mute madi. Okay. So reduce runoff water, and also it check the erosion water and also soil. It check the soil and also water. So what the objective of contour farming? So that is, I think already I discussed in offline classes the different types of soil erosions. So it is not possible to control, or it is not possible. Remember, here I mentioned here, so you cannot go for checking the soil erosion in the gully or rill erosion by the contour, just manipulating the soil or by adapting the contour farming or contour. Okay, is it not rill? It is a rill is, hello, is it audible?
Yes sir, clear to this.
Yes sir.
So the objective is just to reduce the sheet erosion and also reduce the rill erosion and increase the infiltration rate, and also at the same time it reduces the sediment transport. Is it nothing but it check the water and also soil. So what the design criteria, why we have to what the parameters are to be taken into consideration while selecting this contour farming? See here, amount and frequency of the rainfall. I will give you one example. So if it is a heavy rainfall area, is it this contour farming is works good? Heavy rainfall area?
No, sir.
That is why you can also take into consideration of amount and frequency of the rainfall. Is it clear now? Why we have to take this? What are the criteria? Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Very nice. Second one is the row grade. What is that criteria? Row grade. That means the grade is to be provided. So when there is a very low rainfall, we can go for putting the bund on the contour. If it is a slight higher, then you have to provide some the grade for the conservation as well as to save the disposal of that water. Okay, ridge height, that is also you have to take into consideration. Ridge height means, I will tell you the that I think it is not necessary for you. I will tell you ridge height. So again, by designing a bund, so that height is to be taken into account. So that is not required for you. Just I will tell you this few things. Okay, slope steepness. So the bund slope is also taken into consideration. slope length is also taken into consideration. Okay. And also I have discussed how many hydrological soil groups in I discussed previously. How many?
Four.
Yeah, very good. Very nice. Yes. Yes, very good. So there are four soil groups: A, B, C, A section, B section, C section. But future only D section of birth. I think you can also expect D section for the agriculture in the future days. So there are soil groups. How many groups? Soil group A, group B, group C.
Group C.
So that is I already discussed in detail. So it is not necessary to once again recall. Okay. So the vegetation cover and the roughness. By considering these six criteria, you can adapt the contour tillage farming. Okay. Advantages, once again, this is red oche madletko, no problem. So that is advantages enandre, increases the infiltration, increases the water holding capacity, increases the fertility of the soil, decreases the runoff water, and decreases the soil erosion, and increases the crop yield. These are the advantages. Disadvantages is only one, where there is a undulating topography. What is that? Undulating, irregular topography, irregular slope, depressions, all these things, if it is there in a given area, what happens during the rain? The water is stagnated and the water is stand, and that will be making it some field submerged under water. If it is submerged under water, so the crops affected. So that is only the disadvantage. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is the contour cultivation. So I think probably I have already discussed this one. Okay. So this is the cultivation. Vegetative bund is established on the contour vegetative bund. So this doing the cultivation along the contour, that is contour cultivation. So we have discussed in detail about this, what the advantages, how this that will be happen. This is the ridge and furrow cultivation. I think already we have discussed. Okay. So this is one, the dead furrow in red gram. And so what happens? So see here, they have sown the crop along the contour. Okay. Along the contour, or in other words, it is across the slope. Okay. Across the slope. So in between the crop rows, where there is a possibility, so some crop needs some wider space, some crop needs very small space. Whenever there is a crop having the wider space, so you can go for opening the soil and making some furrow. So what happens when there is a slope? So slope, across the slope, if you are open this furrow, so during the flow of water, that water is stored in this furrows and absorbed slowly, infiltrated slowly into the soil. That means to say the maximum water is to be infiltrated. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
So this is how after, if you are taken this crop like this, so after that, this is the view of the cropping system after conservation of the maximum rain water. Okay. This is one. The second, second agronomical practice. So that is strip cropping. So growing of different crops in the alternate strips across the slope. Just I have shown the advantages I have mentioned here. So it reduces the soil erosion. It reduces the runoff production. That means the creation production of runoff. Okay. Maintain the soil fertility. So these are I have given the crops which are suitable for this strip cropping. So one is groundnut. GN is groundnut. Half gram. So that is, I think locally it is called urli. groundnut, kadale, kai. So that is kopi, halasande. So green gram, hesaru. So some of the pulses are also they can use. Okay. Is it clear all of you? Strip cropping.
Yes, sir.
Very nice.
Yes, sir. Yeah,
please, Yaro, Eddie. Please, don't hesitate. Ask me. Yeah, please. Anyone? No? Can I move?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the second one is that is strip cropping. I think already I told you. See, in the strip cropping, so we have two types of strip cropping. One is contour. I have underlined here two types. One is a contour strip cropping, and another one is field strip cropping. So in the contour strip cropping, what happens? So the growing of the crop in the strips are in a band on the contour that is perpendicular to the slope. You remember that is perpendicular to the slope. Growing of a crop in the strips, what strip cropping already I told you, no? So that is contour strip cropping is nothing but growing of a crop in the strips are in a band on contour, across the parallel to the slope. Okay, is it clear? That is one contour strip cropping, how they are growing.
Sir, repeat, sir.
So, contour is there, contour cultivation, you know. So, what is the strip cropping? Growing of a crop in a bands. So, if you are growing of a crop in a band on the contour, that is strip cropping, contour strip cropping.
Sir, along the slope you told, like, what is mean that along the slope? Sir, along or across, perpendicular of the slope?
That is across the slope. It is nothing but the across the slope. Across the slope.
Okay, sir.
Across the slope. So, on the contour or maybe across the slope. That means, so you are, I think already I told you, what do you mean by contour? What do you mean by strip cropping? Strip cropping is a growing of your crops in a bands. Okay. Band after one band after another. So this will be the same thing is cultivated on a contour. If it is cultivated on a contour, that is called the contour strip cropping.
Sir, voice is not clear, sir.
Now it's not clear. Now?
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Strip cropping, growing of a bands on the contour, that is called contour strip cropping. Okay. The field, second one is field strip cropping. See here, what do you mean by strip cropping? It's a growing of a band of crops in a series. Okay. So that is, so growing of a crop in the strips perpendicular to the direction of erosive force. Where there is erosive force is there, perpendicular to that force, you can grow a band of strips. So, where the topography of the land too undulating. Is it clear? I will once again repeat. So, growing of a strip crop on the contour, that is nothing but contour strip cropping. Okay. Wherever there is a undulating topography, in that case, you can just go for growing of a strip cropping in a band perpendicular to the direction of the erosion force. Is it clear now? Anybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any doubt? Any doubt, please? So,
no, sir.
Pardon? 66.
No doubt, sir.
Okay, can I know? Okay. So, you can like strip crop andre. So, strip contour strip crop andre. Strip crop na contour mel grow madtare. So, field strip crop andre. Strip crop na The perpendicular to the direction of the erosion force, yavagandre, yelli undulating irutte alli. Okay, is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the ceramic practice is buffer strip capping. The buffer strip capping, what they have, I have given this in the diagram now. The growing of a legume crops, buffer strip crop, they are growing of a legume crop in strips, maybe wider or the narrow strips. And also they have taken the width, maybe some cases they have uniform width, and in some cases even the variable width they have to grow. Buffer strip cropping is nothing but growing of a legume crops in a strips. Okay. Maybe wider strips or in narrow strips. Okay. Within the what is uniform width or maybe variable width, depending upon the topography of the land. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
So fourth agronomical practice is crop rotation, growing close spaced legumes. Here in the buffer strip cropping, they have grown the legume crops, whatever may be. There is no restriction, but there is no restriction for the width of a strip, or maybe the selection of a crop. So, but in case of crop rotation, you remember crop rotation, growing of a closely spaced legumes, crops alternatively to reduce the erosion and to improve the soil fertility. Just to see the photographs below. So there is two crops. One is legume, right side. The second, left side, there is a maize. It is a cereal. One is a cereal and another one is the legume. Just to, here I will explain. Legumes are the high dense vegetation crops. Compared to the cereal crops. So cereal crops, what happens? They are the erosion permits. Remember, erosion permits, that means more erosion will be happened in case of crops grown, that is crops selected for growing, that is cereals. If we are selected the cereals, they are erosion permitting. That means more of erosion compared to others. But legumes are the high dense vegetation crops, which are erosion resistance crops. So erosion resistance crop. Please rejoin after I will take another 15 minutes. Okay. So at the end of this joining, I will take this your attendance. Okay, is it clear? So is it clear, this one? Crop rotation?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That means leguminous crop followed by the cereal crops. So leguminous crops are the erosion resistance crop, and the cereal crops are the erosion some permitting crops. So if you are reducing the erosion, so alternative rotation is to be needed. That's all. Is it clear, all of you? Is it clear? Okay. Oh, somebody is here. I'm not sure. Any doubt? Something? Hello? Divakar?
Sir.
Okay. Don't worry. Don't. Okay. So this fifth conservational, that is agronomical measure, is a conservational tillage. Conservational tillage is nothing but what is happened. So here, conservation, the word itself, it is indicated, conserve. That means If you want to conserve the water, what is the related parameter? That is, water has to infiltrate it more and more. Is it clear? Is it clear? Is it clear? Did you understand? Conservation means tillage. Conservation tillage. You are doing the tillage for the more and more water is to be infiltrated. Ankit Verma, did you follow me?
Yes, sir.
So, conservation tillage is doing the tillage. What is the tillage? Tillage is, tell me, Ankit Verma.
Sir, tillage is the manipulation of the physical manipulation of the soil to break the soil, make the soil to that condition so that efficient crop belt could be grown on it, sir.
Very good. So, if you are doing this cultivation, tillage operation for the purpose of conservation, that is nothing but the conservation tillage. Conservation tillage, doing the conservation, if you want to go for conserving the water or this conserving the soil, what is the main the parameter? It has to infiltrate more and more water. So, if you are making the scope for the water to be infiltrated more and more, so that is conservation tillage. See here, I have given the definition. The tillage practices is to promote the infiltration of the rainwater without much disturbance of the soil to increase the availability of the water and nutrient for the better crop and the yield of a given plant or crop. Did you clear? Yella conservation tillage, tillage maartta irbekadre ನೀವು ಹೆಚ್ಚು ನೀರನ್ನ ಇನ್ಫಿಲ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಅವಕಾಶ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಅವಾಗ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡೋದಲ್ಲ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬೆನ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲೇನ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಇನ್ಫಿಲ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಕಂಸರ್ವ್ ಕುಡಿಯೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಭೂಮಿ ಕುಡಿಯೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಫುಲ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಅಪ್ಟೇಕ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಯಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ದಿ ಗುಡ್ ಈಲ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಶನ್ ಟೀಲೇಜ್ Okay, next. Sir. The mulch, please.
Nothing, sir.
Okay. Mulch tillage. So, mulch tillage, I think already I have given here. See here. See, the diagram I have given, the conservation tillage. Here, there is a previous crop. Just I will give you some clue here. So, see here, the left-hand side, you can find it, conservation tillage picture. So, there is a previous crop is harvested. So, in this previous crop harvested plot, so just they have put these seeds and grow this minimum disturbance and grow the crop. Did you follow me? This, what the figure I have given here? Photograph. Conservation tillage. Minimum disturbance. Previous harvest ಆಗಿದೆ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬೆನ್ಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗ್ರೋನ್ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಓಕೆ ಮಲ್ಚ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ರೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗಿವನ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ದಿ ಫೋಟೋಗ್ರಾಫ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದಿ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ರೆಸಿಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಮಿನಿಮೈಸ್ ದಿ ಎವಾಪರೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಿ ವಾಟರ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಮಲ್ಚ್ ಟೀಲೇಜ್ ಡಿಡ್ ಯು ಫಾಲೋ ಮೀ ಮಲ್ಚ್ ಅಂದ್ರೇನು Tillage with mulch crop residues, mulching of a crop residues or any stubbles, crop stubbles or stalk, mulch on the surface of the soil to increase the infiltration rate and minimize the evaporation, water loss. Minimize the water loss through evaporation. Did you follow me? Is it clear all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Next type of mulching
sir.
We have. Yeah, please.
Yes, sir. There sir, last slide alli erosion permittivity helidralu sir. The erosion permittivity means vegetation will depend agutte andre means root system will depend agutta sir.
Yeah, that is the first thing, that is the vegetation cover is the vegetation, what is that vegetation cover is the important rather than the, what is that, the roots. The second preference is for the root holding. Soil mass held by the root. So that is also helps You know, if you see here, if the land, the entire land is covered with the vegetation, is it the soil is disturbing?
No, sir.
Yes. So the soil acid is reduces. Okay. Is it clear? So say, sometime what happens, if you compare to what your question is, if you compare to two situations where there is a crop is there and where there is a no crop, only bare land. See here. Wherever there is a crop, plant or crop, so plant or tree or crop, that will holding the moisture. If there is no crop, only a bare land, so in which situation the highest soil loss?
Bare.
Yes, bare land. So that is why the roots are also helping in that situation. Is it clear, all of you? What I believe?
Sure.
Okay.
Yes,
so this mulching bandaga, there are three types: crop residue, aki. We are using the crop residues for the mulching. So this is one crop residue mulching. Second one is pebbles or stone mulching, and also third one is vertical mulch. I will tell you vertical mulch. So just to see this soil or the dust mulch, the another one. So just to see this region after immediately, okay, crop residue mulch, just to collect this the straws or the wooden chips or sawdust, anything, so you can spread on the surface of the soil in the crop grown area, so it will be minimized. Already I told you, explained. Second type, that is a stone mulching, that is whatever the pebbles are there, I have given in this table picture. So around the crop or the plant, so if you are spreading the mulch stone, that will conserve the rain. How it will be conserving? So see here, so it will be minimizing evaporation loss. How it will be reduce the evaporation loss? It will be breaking the, that is what is that, so the contact with the surface of the soil with the atmosphere. So what happens? The movement of water, that will be restricted in the stone mulch. The third one is, that is the soil mulching. Soil mulching is nothing but the dust mulch. I have given the table here. So how this moisture is conserved? How the mulch is conserved in the dust mulch? If you are making the dust mulch, is nothing but the disturbing the soil. The upper layer of the soil is to be disturbed, making the dust. So how it will be conserved rain? You are telling me, anyone? Yaradro.
Sir, dustally forces the water na bara, sir.
What is your name? Okay, yeah, tell me how that the crop residue, so stone mulch, matte dust mulch, vertical mulch, illi how that water is conserved. ಒಂದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಡಸ್ಟ್ ಹೌ ದಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಇನ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಮಲ್ಚ್ ಆರ್ ಡಸ್ಟ್ ಮಲ್ಚ್ ಅಮೃತ ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ಅಮೃತ ಅಮೃತ ಹೇಳಿ ಅಮೃತ ಅಮೃತ ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ಹೇಳಿ ಅಮ್ಮ ಈಗ ಡಸ್ಟ್ ಮಲ್ಚ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಹೌ ದಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಡಸ್ಟ್ ಮಲ್ಚ್ ಹೇಳಿ ಅಮೃತ ಹಲೋ ಹೇಳಿ ಅಮ್ಮ ಹೇಳಿ ಅಮೃತ ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ಏನೋ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆಯಮ್ಮ
ಸರ್ ಇಟ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದಿ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಎವಾಪೊರೇಟಿವ್ ಲಾಸ್
ಹೌ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಎನಿಬಡಿ 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 ಓಕೆ ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಮ್ಮ ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಓಕೆ ಎನಿಬಡಿ
ಸರ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಡಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಸರ್
ಪಡ ಚೈತ್ರ ಹೇಳಿ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಹಾ ಹೇಳಿ
ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಡಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಟೈನಿ ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಸರ್
ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಡಸ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ದಿರೇಶ್
ಟೈನಿ ಪೋರ್ಸ್
ಹಾ ಟೈನಿ ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಹೌ ದಟ್
ಇಟ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಸ್
ವಾಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವ್
Sir, so it absorbs more water, sir.
So, okay. Any other?
Sir, it slows down the water falling on it so that it could be evaporated more, filtrated more, and less loss of evaporation would be there, sir, and more infiltration, so it would be more moist, sir.
Yes, that low evaporation will be done by this method. How that will be? How it reduces?
Sir, it reduces the fall impact, sir. Fall impact, sir. Like if it will fall, like it will give more time to absorb. So it means it would be like less erosive velocity would be there, sir.
So the third photograph, they have disturbing the soil, the top soil near the crops or the plants. So here. What the water is always moving from the soil to atmosphere through the capillary force. Did you heard this one? Capillary force.
Yes,
capillary sir. Capillary movement. The capillary movement of water from soil to the atmosphere. So when there is a top soil, so that capillary tube is, if you are breaking this capillary tube, what happens? The movement of water from the soil to the atmosphere, that will be stopped. So in this way, the water, whatever the water, the moisture is, water or the moisture in the soil, that will be not evaporated. So in this way, the water is conserved by the dust mulch. Is it clear, all of you?
Sir,
yeah, tell me.
Sir, but when we are disturbing the capillaries of the soil, then we are also letting the humidity and the moisture and content in the soil to be exposed to the atmosphere, and then the losses would be more aggressive. So how can we say that?
No. Whatever the water holding within the soil, no. If you are that water, the soil water, how? That soil water is to be moved from from soil to the atmosphere. How that will be moving? It will be moving through the capillary movement only. Okay? Is it clear? Capillary movement. Yes, if you are breaking the top, that is the tube, if your capillary tube is breaking, what happens? Breaking the tube, so the movement, upward movement of this, what is the upward movement of the water, that will be stopped at the where you have what is that breaking of that capillary. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So that is why, so that the loss of water through the evaporation, that will be minimized. Yes. So that will be minimizes in the dust mulching. The vertical mulching. So usually vertical mulching is done in the black soil. Remember black soil. So that is opening of a trench across the slope. So across the slope, if you are opening the trench, so whatever the water that will be flowing, that will be infiltrated. And this trench, vertical trench, is filled with the crop residues. And that water is infiltrated. More and more water is to be infiltrated. These are all the types of mulching. Did you clear, all of you? Did you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So coming to the today's, actually I have started this business today. So because of this the discussion about the agronomical already I have discussed, but here just within 10 minutes I will give you the highlights. Tomorrow I will next class I will continue the same thing. Okay, mechanical, that is agronomical measures are over. So next, coming to the mechanical or the engineering measures, I think already I have shown, this is the contour bund. Contour bund is, that is contour bunding. Bunding, bund is earthen embankment. If you are constructed the bund on the contour, it is the contour bund. So this contour bund is provided, constructed where the area which receives the rainfall is to somebody
less than 700 or 600.
So sometimes even though they have to go for less than 600 also. Okay, so less than 700 mm rainfall, they have to go for contour bunding. Okay, so this here I already closed you explained. This is the contour bund, is the construction of earthen embankment. So are the bund which is constructed on the contour where the area which receives the rainfall is less than 700. So 600 to 700, they have to take into consideration less than 700 annually for conserving the maximum rainwater. In this case, so you can go for constructing the contour bund. See, here in the contour bund, just I have given one thing. So you can find it at the middle of this. Visible cursor? My cursor? The cursor is visible?
Yes, sir.
So this is the contour bund. So if it is a, see here, this is the entire field. You can, here there is a road. You can find it road. From this road, you have this area of 1 hectare, maybe 1 hectare. You taken 1 hectare. So in this hectare, in this area, so they have to put the bund in the different directions, different purposes. So just see here, this is the boundary of the, what I show in this area, this is the boundary of his or land. Okay, so at the end of the boundary of the land, if you are going for constructing the bund, that is nothing but which type of bund I have given here?
Field bund.
Yes, very nice. It's the field bund. Is it clear now? So next, if it is a road here, if the road, after the road, you have leave some space and making the bunding to demarcate or bifurcate your land, that is the marginal bunds. They are the marginal bunds. Okay. So coming to this, see here, this is the area you can bifurcate it. So this is the entire area. This is the your entire area. Within that, so if you want to bifurcate, if you want to go for constructing the, again, bunding, contour bunding, so your area may be 10 hectares. Okay. Just I have given the example. In the 10 hectares, if your boundary bounds are, bunds are putting, put on the bund in the boundary. So that is field boundary bunds. And near the bifurcation of the land with the road, whatever the bunds you have made it, so that is marginal bunds. Within that area, the bigger area, If you want to go for putting some the other burns, see here. So in the bifurcated area, this is the contour bund if you want to put in the given location. So this is the contour bund. Okay, contour bund. The sides of this contour bund, so that is contour bund is constructed across the slope, or on the contour. So just on either side of this contour bund, so you can find it a bund that is called the side bunds. Side bunds, remember, side bunds, side bund. In the within the field, so in the contour bounded area, if you are putting one bund lateral, perpendicular to the contour bund, so that is nothing but the lateral bunds, lateral bunds. Okay, so this is the area you have bifurcated with the here there is a one contour bund and there is a another here, this is the another contour bund. In between the two contour bund, if you want to put some more, one more the bund, that is called the supplemental bund. That is called the supplemental bund. Is it clear all of you? Is it clear all of you? I will discuss tomorrow next class. Is it clear? This one?
Yes, sir.
So next class. Yeah, please. Yeah.
Any doubt? What is the necessary of supplemental bund?
Supplementary bund. So there is a two bund. There is a one contour bund is there, another contour bund is there. Unfortunately, so who is that? Dilip? No, Dilip. Asking Dilip or?
Sir.
Yeah. So there are two bunds here. There is a one contour bund and another contour bund. So unfortunately, I will give you an example situation. So there is a contour bund. The bund distance between the two contour bund is 30 meter. For example, okay, did you clear, Dilip?
Yes, sir.
If it is a some situation, what happens in your land, there is a, if you want to put the two bunds, the you need 30 meter. If it is a 30 meter, you can put two bunds. Okay, so unfortunately your land is 45 meter. Okay, did you clear this 45 meter?
Sir.
For the 45 meter, what is the length you have to put contour bund, the origin, the distance between the two bunds is 30. But unfortunately, if you are constructed putting the bunds at 30, so another 15 meter is left over. Is it not?
Yes, sir.
So in that situation, what happens? It is not necessary to go for once again 15 meter, once again one more bund. So you can put the two bind, contour bind at the one, the after the 45 meter, there is one more. So, but length is too high. So in that case, what happens? Because of this length, it is higher than the recommended one. So you can go for one more supplemental bind to reduce or to conserve more effectively that water inside in that particular area. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear, Dilip?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Okay. So this is how. So we have to put this. What is that? The supplemental bund. Supplemental bund. So supplemental bund is necessary where there is the width of the two bund is more than your the required or the, more than the your required. So in that situation, so we have to go for adapting this supplemental bunds. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes, sir.
So, any doubt? You have 5 minutes there. How many are there?
89, so, sir.
Okay. You take attendance.
Sorry, sir.
Okay. Any doubts? Any doubt? Where is that? Ankit Verma ji. Verma, hello, good room. Gopal is there?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Gopal?
Sir.
Okay. Is it clear now?
Yes.
Okay. No, other ICFJs didn't. And also this, where is Victor is there, okay. Victor is here. Any doubt? No doubt, no? Let us see you next class.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye. See you, bye. Bye. Take care.